Hey, what's going on, guys? Today we're going to be going through a squat workout, and I haven't quite decided how exactly we're going to be squatting today. We're either going to do sets of 20 with just two plates and burn it out, or we're going to go to a more powerlifting style of training, which is going to be lower reps at a higher weight. I'm not really sure where my strength is at since it's been quite a while since I have squatted, and since we're getting back into the start of things, I want to be really safe and gentle and start back slow instead of, you know, going back to the weights I was doing and playing in the fours again and just like absolutely destroying my body and hurting myself, putting myself out of the gym way longer than it would take to just get back there, which would probably be like 3 weeks, maybe tops, with proper training, proper sleep, and proper eating. So what I like to do is I like to warm up with the bar. I'm not too big into stretching right before the whole lift, before everything. I think there are some studies that go against actually stretching a lot before your lift. It can actually cause micro tears, which in turn, when you put weight on it, can actually tear the whole muscle itself. There are varying conflicting beliefs on this, but I've kept with this my whole life. I've just done this way my whole life, so I'm gonna keep doing that. So we're gonna start off with the bar, warm up really nice and gentle, and then we're gonna go into a plate, then a plate and a quarter. I'm a really big fan of warming up slow, even if it's a couple reps. I just want my body to adjust to the weight, get used to it, and yeah, especially when you don't have too many meals in you, you want to make sure that you're really taking the precautions, because one buckle the wrong way and you can hurt yourself. So let's get to it. So we're gonna get my sleeves out here, and these are just regular neoprene 7mm sleeves. These are SBD. I swear by these. I really like them. I've used them all my life with lifting, and I've tried many different sleeves, but I find these to be the best. You want them not to be too crazy tight, unless you're competing, of course, and then, you know, you get the plastic bag and the baby powder and everything, and you try to just like wedge it on there as much as you can. But, you know, at this point in my life where I'm just hitting regular numbers for me, I think, you know, just being able to pull them up is good enough. It also helps if you have really small calves, so, you know, that's why I keep my calves small, get the knee sleeves up. So a typical stance for the squat is, there are many different ways, and don't let one trainer tell you there's one specific way to do it, because there really is not. You essentially just want to align yourself in a comfortable position with the bar, and we can go over this in other videos where you do high bar, low bar, or a hybrid. I like to do more of a hybrid. I've done all of them. I did high bar. I've squatted over 400 pounds with high bar. I've done low bar, and a nice hybrid I find is the best. That's the one that got me 500 pounds. And for me, for my body, you know, you gotta look at your body. What are your strengths? What are you working on? For me, my quads really aren't that great, but my glutes and my hamstrings are extremely powerful, and they're over dominant in terms of like when I lift in powerlifting with squats, deadlifts anyways. So I use that to my advantage. I like to take a little bit of a wider stance. I like to point my toes out a little bit, and I like to drop my hips, find that parallel, and then drop a little below it and get that rebound. And you guys will see that in today's squat video. And again, this is just more of a workout, but I'm just gonna take you guys through a little bit of what I do. So the next video will be really in depth. Typically, I wouldn't recommend doing legs right after you do back, you know, but I didn't go too crazy yesterday on my lower back, so I didn't do any deadlifts or anything. So we're just gonna keep it nice and chill today. Okay, so approach the bar, line yourself up. The main thing I want to really express with squats, slow down on your walkout. I see so many dudes and girls just walking it out really fast. So much energy wasted, so much chance of injury when it gets heavy. Slow it down, man, slow it down. You don't look cool when you do it all fast. I did that stuff, it looks stupid. You wanna be really controlled, like you got this. Not like you're hasty and you're trying to pull everything together out of your ass to make it happen. Okay. So one of the things you want to do when you squat, you definitely want to remember to brace your body. And what I mean by that is, you know, we'll go over it in another video where I'll get different angles and everything. But essentially you want to line yourself up with the bar, wherever you like to hold it. Could be here, here, here. Some guys like to hold out here if they're huge. And then we also got the camber bar over here, which I still haven't used. I'm working myself up to it. That's like, if you can take one thing away from this channel and from the way I lift, is I'm very patient. I don't push it, because I have pushed it. And you know, I was young and dumb and you know, I just got lucky, I guess. But I always listen to my body and I know when I need to stop, when I gotta chill out and not go absolutely insane, because then that's just gonna, I love to lift, so I don't wanna be out of the gym for a long time. I don't wanna be injured. And even though this is light, every set has to be the same. So if it's the bar, I walk it out the same way as if it were 500 pounds. If it's a plate, same way as if it's 500 pounds. Doesn't matter what it is. You get into this habit and routine of lifting that never fluctuates, never changes. Everything is the same. The walkout, the breathing, the moment you breathe, the bracing, all that shit is gonna be the same no matter what. And it's hot today. It makes it hard to breathe. Okay. If you look, it's right in between my traps and my rear delts. And this, of course, is a luxury of having big traps, but I trained for it, and you can too. And the bar just sits really nicely. It's like a little shelf. Big breath. So we have now earned the upgrade to two plates. So here's my belt, and I'm gonna make a video by itself of the importance of a belt and what you actually can do with a belt. Because I see a lot of people just wear belts, but they don't actually use them. They just think the belt is magically gonna help them with something. But if you understand the science behind the use of a belt, you're gonna be able to effectively use it, get your money's worth, and prevent yourself from injury and lift more. So it's a win-win. Now, typically I wouldn't use a belt until around three plates or so, but I'm weak as shit right now and I'm getting back into it. And again, listen to your body. Don't rush it. I don't need to prove anything. So I'm gonna wear my belt. My back's, lower back's feeling tight, and I'm gonna listen to myself and not be stupid. So you put the belt on and we're gonna see how two plates feels, because I still don't know how these feel. A plate and a quarter felt fine, but we're gonna see how this feels. Now, with a belt, you typically wanna make sure that you are, this is why like a lot of powerlifters are fat, one of the reasons. The fatter you are, the more you can push out on your belt. So if I just push out as hard as I can brace against this thing. And then if I tighten my abs against the belt, oh man, now you're using it. Now you're actually using it to its benefit. You're getting your money's worth, and you're protecting yourself and you're able to lift more. So just like Stan Efferding said, you know, you add a plate, you add a gimmick. Add a plate, add a gimmick. You added a plate, you add a belt. Next plate, we get some wrist wraps. Next after that, if we go further, you know, we'll see what happens. Okay, so that's surprisingly very easy. Okay, so now we got three plates on the bar here. We're gonna use the belt, we're gonna use the wrist wraps, and we're gonna implement the chalk. And we're gonna see how many I get. My goal, I think, you know, this should be a good top set to start at. We start at three plates, getting back into squatting. I wanna do three sets of five. We're gonna see how it goes. I always like to underplay it, and if I go more, I go more. And believe me, like, this was a totally different mindset that I had when I was actually lifting. When I was lifting, I was like, no, I'll go for 10. Because mentally, if you find you're like doing one, you're like, oh shit, I have another nine left. You already feel defeated. Okay, so I like to trick myself sometimes. Yeah, we're gonna go for three. Feel good, we'll go for four. I got one more, five. I got one more. By the time you know it, you're at 12, so. Now I got every wrist strap on the market. So I can do a review on them all eventually. I got the gangster wraps, I got the SPD wraps, I had everything. I had the Inzer wraps. Literally every wrap that they made I bought. Good. I don't feel as springy in the bottom, and I think that's because my glutes aren't as big as they used to be. Definitely like legs and everything shrunk. So it's gonna be a bit of a training session, bit of a battle to get back to where I was, but it won't be difficult. If I just maintain slow, steady pace, I know I can get there pretty easy. It's just gonna take some time. So right now we're gonna focus on three sets of five with three plates. After this, we're gonna back down. We're gonna do two plates for pauses. Might go up to 10, might go up to 8. We're gonna see how it feels. Might go up to 12. The thing I wanna focus on right now is just keeping everything braced and tight, because the muscles, the central nervous system, everything isn't nearly as powerful as it used to be when it was primed and ready to be doing these kind of exercises. So you wanna start lighter. You always wanna go slower, not moving slower, but slower in terms of progress. And in the long run, you will come out a champion, you will be injury free for the most part, and you'll just feel better. It's about longevity, you know, and that it's not about just burning right through the wick as fast as you can. It's about longevity. You wanna see how long that candle can stay aflame. You wanna enjoy life, you wanna be strong, because when you're gonna be, you know, like 50, 60 years old, you wanna still be a powerhouse and healthy. You don't wanna be crippled and mangled and being like, well, back in my day, you know, I squatted this and that like an idiot. And not that squatting heavy is an idiot, but if you squat like an idiot, you know, we see them all the time in the gym. It's just recipe for disaster. And it's that momentary like Instagram ego lift. And I'm talking from experience because I did all of this shit. And I'll post videos of like the stupid crap I've done, like bouncing the bar with three plates on my neck, you know, coming up so super explosively and just having it literally like a foot off my neck bouncing, just crushing my spine. I was a freak. I was like mentally just like something was not there. And I just wanted to like destroy myself. I guess for Instagram or who knows, whatever, for my own mental, whatever it may be. So anyways, that's the bit of advice I want to leave you guys with, is just be patient, man. Life is a really long journey. And funny enough, you know, ironic that you'll actually get there faster if you do it this way. So now I want to talk about something rather interesting, which you guys might notice your second set is actually stronger and easier than your first set. And many times this happens because your body wakes up after the first set. That's how I like to look at it. It warms up, everything's lubricated, so to speak. Everything's kind of stretched out and ready to go. And I find my second set is usually, if I'm doing the same weight, if it's a low rep set, usually going to be better. And so you might be inclined, oh, I can go heavier. Stick to the program, stick to the plan, and you'll get there, man. Trust me. So then next week we could even jump up to, for me, a big jump. We're gonna see how it goes. It could be 25 pounds each side, so we could go to 365. And we'll see how it feels for three sets of five, maybe. And again, the key is to play it slow. You know, we're not competing right now. We're not doing anything crazy. So it's just training for longevity and health and to be jacked as fuck. So you want to keep that in mind and be humble, keep the ego in check. And that's really the main thing that I've learned. Just train, just get the job done, get the numbers done. Pause at the end. Daddy's coming back. Homophobic, man, you're the xenophobic. Staring at my jeans, watching my genitals fall. That's my motherfucking balls, you better let go. They belong in my scrotum, you'll never get hold of them. Hey, it's me, Versace. What? Somebody shot me, and I was just checking the mail. Get it stuck in the mail. How many records you expecting to sell after your second LP? Something you want to focus on when you're doing pause squats is to actually pause. And I made this mistake many times. I would think like half a second is a pause. It's not a pause. The point of a pause is to actually sit in it. Just absolutely kill all and any momentum and any sort of rebound that you may have and really get to lifting as best as you can without any sort of help. And to make it really difficult for you so that you're really training every single body part in that movement as best as you can. Cool. So now we're going to focus on doing some stiff-legged deficit deadlifts. This is more of an advanced movement. I wouldn't recommend you doing this if you're just starting out. I like to incorporate this in my leg workouts because it really, for me, targets my hamstrings and my glutes and just really helps me with that posterior chain. And what I find it really helps with, of course, is the squatting. Of course, deadlifting, but squatting where you're able to keep tight in that position where you're like this. So the back here is just holding the movement. You want to straighten your legs as much as you can. And we're starting with a little deficit today. Usually I do 4 inches. This is a 2-inch deficit lift, lift off the ground. So we're just going to start real slow again, reinforcing that we're beginning slow and we're going into the movement very slowly. And I can't reiterate that enough, man. So many people get injured from just doing crazy shit that they're not ready for. No bouncing, nothing. You really want to feel that stretch on the hamstrings. And again, really light. You just want to make sure that you're getting back to the swing of things so that when you do start ramping up the weights, when we get to 2, 3, 4 plates on deficits, it's not going to blow something out of our back or our hamstrings or whatever, because our body's going to be really ready for it and really primed. And so once you guys start to see the progression that I'm making, you're going to be like, holy shit, he's doing everything with the exact same form at a much higher weight. And with that, we're pretty much gonna end this vlog. My battery's running out anyways. Too lazy to go all the way upstairs and grab another battery. But I did get a new camera, which I'll show you guys in the next vid. It's a Lambo vlog, going to get it, which will be fun. And then we'll do an unboxing here. And for this workout, I'm gonna do another 2 sets of this. At the same weight, I might put on a 25 on each side as well. And typically, I'd like to do some leg press or something like that. I don't have that luxury here in the garage. I'd have to go to the gym for that. I did have a leg press, as you guys remember, but I got rid of it because I didn't have space for the car. So maybe one day when I have more space, I'll be able to have a full gym setup, which is my dream. So with that, I hope you guys enjoyed today's workout, little quick home workout with, you know, whatever I have here. And let me know what your questions are down below in the comments, and I'll catch you guys in the next workout video in the next video. See you later.